Cancel culture is really f***ing cringe. I mean, I think it's so unnecessary that people are getting canceled and have their whole platform taken away. And have so much random ass people that act like they have never done anything or said anything controversial, hating on them on every single platform they can find that the person owns, till this creator gives them the reaction they want or even stops making content entirely.
Alright, so do you know any creator that got canceled for some controversial shit they said or just some tweet that they posted like 4 years ago that people pulled out of nowhere? I mean, I swear to God, whenever I see like white creators apologizing for saying the N-word 4 or 5 years ago in a tweet or in some DM message, I just think it's really cringe that people really went that far and they have so much hate for someone to go look for some shit and then try to point it out 4 or 5 years later, and that's actually a point for people. Like, that this is actually a reason for someone to be like, let's try to end this person's career now for something they did back when they were, I don't know, like, teenagers. Like, come on. Let's take Only Jay as an example. She's like a famous TikToker. Bro, that shit sounds so great. I don't like the word tick. Anyways, she's a famous TikToker. Last time I checked, she had about like 17 million followers, but I could be wrong since I don't use TikTok because I think it's kind of cringe. But you've probably seen her videos before. She basically talks about random facts about like humans and psychology and shit, or just whatever world. Like, it's always like some random shit, but it's pretty interesting. She just talks about a bunch of like random facts and like basically teaches you stuff. I always thought it was pretty cool. But like, just the concept of teaching people random things has always been something I like. So yeah, that's exactly what she does. This may be because I loved doing this when I was younger myself, but I don't know why. Point is, I like what she does. I think she makes cool content. So the reason that I brought this up is that she was supposedly canceled for like 2 big reasons. And I want to talk about that today to give an example about the thing I'm talking about, what I think is so stupid about cancel culture and people getting canceled for dumb shit, in my opinion. So the first reason that supposedly got her canceled is her making a TikTok about talking about how all men suck. And yeah, that's basically just it. When I hear this shit, I'm like, come on, man. Like, this is a really good example of what I said about people being way too f***ing sensitive for no reason. Because as you might have noticed, I'm a man and I don't agree with the statement she made. But if that's her opinion, that's cool for her. But if it really bothers me that much that I want to take action, the only action I'm going to take is unfollow her. Or just, like, you can do the not interested shit. Get it out of my videos and watch the shit that I do want to watch. I mean, like, you can just close the tab. You know, you can just close the app. You're out. You don't have to watch it. No one's forcing you. But the fact that you are choosing to watch this over and over again, talk about it, even make TikToks replying to it because she said she doesn't like men. Oh, let's cancel her. Really, man? Like, come on. People really took it seriously and felt attacked and shit because some rich and famous TikTok girl said she doesn't like men. Like, come on, man. Like, do you not have anything to do with your day for you to try and cancel her? Then again, I get the point that they're trying to make because it's obviously pretty stupid for her to say that all men are something because she simply doesn't know all men and she can't know that. So obviously her point is just, like, factually is not true. Like, she can't know that. It's not just because one specific, like, person caused trauma to her that happened to be a man means that every single man in the world is the same as that one person. Like, I get that she might think that way or feel that way, but pretty stupid point. Like, so I get what the people that are trying to cancel her are trying to do, but come on. Because then again, I also believe that she should be able to say whatever the hell she wants on her platform that she created and built up from the ground, and that no one should, like, try to censor what she's saying just because you don't agree with it or it hurt your feelings, because you can just close the tab, close the app, go do something else, but you decide to give it your attention. And I think that's more you, says more about you than it says about the person being childish and saying some dumb shit, saying something that they believe in and you don't. So the second thing they tried to cancel for was her saying the N-word and someone, like, in DM messages. And I should specify that at the time when they were trying to cancel her, this message was already 4 or 5 years old, but that doesn't matter in the world of cancel culture. I personally don't really give a shit what people call me. If they really want to call me a hard R and that makes them happy on the inside, I'm just like, all right, buddy, I'm not going to f*** with you, but, like, that's what you want to say, that's your issue. But apparently not a lot of people think the same way and think that they should take action against people using words that hurt them. I mean, I don't know about you, but I'm not gonna let some random ass white person who wants to say an N-word ruin my day just because he said a word that I didn't like. There's no way I'm gonna go with that. Whenever black people get called a N-word and I see like people even going out of their way to start fighting people and shit because you can't say that, you're white, blah, 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 that's disrespectful and history and shit. I mean, you're right, but like, are you really gonna fight someone for that? Because in my opinion, as soon as you start fighting someone for something they said to you, you already lost that fight, because that shows that you don't know how to either verbally come back at them or just let it go. So the only option you can think of is to actually physically try to hurt them. And I don't think that's the solution to someone calling you a word. But anyways, yeah, Jay has said the N-word like 4 or 5 years ago. I think it's more now because this incident was probably like last year or even longer ago. Anyways, yes, you said it. So like, said a hard R while arguing with someone like 4 or 5 years ago. And people pulled that up to try to expose her. At first, there was only screenshots of these messages. And then she denied that that was her and that it's photoshopped and shit. And then the person who has this chat, like, screen recorded it. And then she tried to still deny, but at some point she agreed with it. Because they said you can't photoshop a video, which is really stupid. You can edit videos. It's not that hard. You can fake shit. But hey, she agreed to saying it and she apologized and shit. And TikTok, which is like her main content like platform, her comment sections were filled with people saying address it and referring to when she was getting those messages about saying that and she was denying it or not saying anything about it. Cause yeah, when you say address it, then she's gonna make a video and say sorry about something she did 4 or 5 years ago, and then you'll be happy with your life now because she said sorry. But the funny part is that usually whenever they say sorry, they still don't accept it. So then I'm like, what did you want them to do? Like, delete their channel? Like, what did you want? Yeah, I mean, it's pretty stupid. At this point, these social media arguments and like people getting canceled for the most stupid shit or shit they did way too long ago for it to still be like such a big deal makes me think that I either have really thick skin or people are just getting really f***ing sensitive about anything, or they're just bored, or I don't know what it is, but there's no way that people are actually getting that offended to the extent where you want to take action and take time and energy out of your day to go dig for shit to take people down. Like, come on, man. Like, damn. I mean, it really feels like people are just getting offended by anything that is not their opinion nowadays, and it's pretty whack. I mean, it really just feels like people are just getting offended whenever someone doesn't have the exact same opinion as them nowadays, and it's like pretty fucked up because of this, a lot of content that people want to make can't be made. I mean, you can technically make it, but if you want to make it big, you got to follow the algorithm and shit. You got to make everyone happy. But as soon as you say something controversial, the chances that you get canceled or stuff are so big that people don't take the risk to be themselves online, which paints this really fake picture on any social media platform just because people do this shit. And it kind of fucks up the most fun part of social media, in my opinion. That's it. Yeah.
Hey, looked in the mirror, that's the only nigga that I got competition with. Love it up, baby, for real, I ain't doing no exhibition shit. Hey, like Danny, gotta get on my show, he ain't gotta do no all this shit. I just had to cap him up from on the road.